Sysdig closes the cloud-native operations gap by providing the insight and control needed for enterprises to progress into dynamic cloud-native architectures. Sysdig Platform 2.0 is the first tool that provides unified visibility across your microservices, containers, and Kubernetes. By unlocking rich sources of data, our platform solves a ton of the issues you'll face in operating modern applications. Image scanning, compliance, availability and performance monitoring, troubleshooting, runtime security, forensics, you get the picture. A single tool to gain visibility into the operational status of your software and infrastructure, all at the vast scale that enterprises require. So whether you're in ops, security, or you're a service owner, Sysdig enables you to identify the indicators that are important to you. This means that we can all triage issues faster across clusters, nodes, services, or applications, which will reduce your operational overhead. So imagine, if you're in ops and operating a multi-cloud Kubernetes cluster, then you'll want to ensure your dev team can continuously deploy their applications with zero disruption. Translated, this means you'll be expected to solve infrastructure health and performance problems swiftly, alongside meeting security standards and compliance regulations. So let's dig in to how we can do this with Sysdig. So here I can see two clusters, one in GKE and one OpenShift on AWS. It's cool to have that multi-cloud visibility because at a glance I can see key indicators such as cluster health and capacity, compliance and risk. Looking at the OpenShift cluster, I can see resources and capacity look good, but some security compliance checks have failed. I can drill down into the nodes to locate the issue on one of the hosts or see if it's a cluster-wide problem. The issue seems to be contained to one node, so let's check the details of its specific compliance report. Here in the Docker configuration files section, I can see how the permissions for the Docker engine are too open. Sysdig even suggests some remediation steps to address the issue. So great, I'll get this fixed, but when did this happen and how? While the report just shows the last check, with Sysdig I can see my compliance status over time using compliance dashboards. They're an invaluable way for security teams to analyze compliance trends over time. So looking at this graph, I can see this happened 2 days ago, but there were no other changes that affected my compliance posture. Furthermore, going into the secure audit section, I can then search for commands that modified my Docker configuration file and find out how it happened. So let's change this up. If you're a service owner, what's important is the applications and services, whether they are up and healthy, performance monitoring and troubleshooting, and if there are any software vulnerabilities in their container images that need to be fixed. From the overview again, I can look at the same infrastructure, but now from an application point of view. This is something that makes Sysdig pretty unique. I can see that on the GKE cluster, CPU resources are close to capacity. Now, is this impacting any of my applications? When I drill down into namespaces, I can see one of my apps is impacted. It's slow, and it's probably because the number of pods is below my expected scale. So let's look at the event feed, which will give me a chronological list of events. Anything from downtime, deploys, performance alerts, and also security events like runtime threats or image scanning results. Here I can see how some pods couldn't be scheduled. For devs, these events are so useful because you can get notified if apps need to be rebuilt when new vulnerabilities are found on your images. Let's continue troubleshooting by drilling down into the microservices view inside this app. Here we can confirm which service is having the problem and open a monitoring dashboard for that deployment. Okay, so from the moment we deployed a new version of our app, response times have increased and we're serving less requests. At the same time, just one pod is running and two are unavailable. From the events, we can tell not enough CPU resources are available to schedule the remaining pods. What can we do to fix this? Checking this graph, we can see pods are requesting much more CPU than they actually need. I'm going to lower CPU requests to be somewhere close to what's actually needed so that all of our pods can be scheduled within the available resources. Having risk, health, and performance together in one place for all teams helps to run reliable containers and microservices in production and reduces operational overhead. Doing this without Sysdig would require multiple products, multiple agents, and lots of work to correlate all of the data manually between them. Not fun. So that's Sysdig Platform 2.0, unified visibility and security for cloud-native architectures.